is where it all begins. And this is where it all began. In the small city of Trent in northern Italy, 75 years ago, a young 23-year-old girl called Chiara Lubich. Through a sequence of acts of love in her everyday life, she understood that we are all called to be one, to love. It was a freezing cold winter's morning when her mom wanted one of the children to go out and get some milk. Really, one of her sisters could have gone so that Chiara could study. And the farm was miles and miles away. No one wanted to go. But then Chiara, she volunteered. She set off in the snow and ice. And on the journey, she was suddenly filled with deep joy and the realization that God loved her immensely. And right there and then, she decided to respond to this love with her love. She was then surrounded by a group of friends who wanted to share this new life.
Then came the Second World War. Every corner of Trent was bombarded. One day, in May 1943, the bombing worsened. She and her family fled from their home into the woods, where they spent the night under the stars, watching their city being destroyed.
Chiara understood that, even though her family depended on her, she had to remain in Trent. Her family would leave the city, but she would stay for all that was growing around her. She wept, knowing it would be hard for all concerned. Then a phrase came to her, love conquers all. Love conquers all.
She spoke to her father and explained that she needed to remain in the city. He understood and gave her his blessing. When they walked on, she shared her plans with her mom, but she was very upset and did not understand at all. When they had to part company, she put the backpack onto her mom's back. It felt so cruel, but she knew there was a different plan for her life.
When she reached the city, it was devastated. The first person she met there was a woman who was inconsolable. She grabbed Chiara and screamed, "Four of my family are dead. Four of my family." Consoling the woman, Chiara understood that she had to let go of all her sufferings in order to take on the sufferings of those around her.
She was walking through the city looking for her friends. Just like a miracle, they had all survived. However, all their dreams were shattered by the war. Homes destroyed, fiancé killed, studies curtailed, and works of art obliterated. Her brother Gino summed it all up, showing her around the hospital, which was full of corpses.
"See, Chiara, everything is vanity of vanities."
Chiara and her friends understood clearly that there was only one thing that could not be destroyed. God, love.
They would meet in the air raid shelter several times a day. They took a copy of Gospels with them and began to read it with a new sense of purpose. Various sayings struck them. "I give you a new commandment. Love one another as I have loved you."
Sometimes, when going to the shelters, it meant risking their lives to help the elderly or disabled get there. They looked at each other and said, "I am ready to give my life for you."
"And I for you."
"And I for you."
"And I for you."
"And I for you."
"Love your enemies."
"What? Even to those who constantly criticize us?"
"Yes, love everyone."
"Where two or more are gathered in my name, there I am in their midst."
Despite the horrors of the war, they felt light and joy that God was with them.
And one night, by candlelight, they read,
"Father, May they all be one.
They felt that they have been born for that moment, for unity, to bring unity to the world.
And soon, this group grew to 500 people, male and female, young and old, married and single, all on fire.
And the rest is history. This ideal of unity spread far beyond the city of Trent, from Italy to Europe to other continents.
It all started within the Catholic Church and then spread on to other Christian denominations. Lutherans, Anglicans, Orthodox, Protestants.
Also, friendship grew with other faiths: Islam, Judaism, Hinduism, Buddhism, Sikhism, and many more.
And also people with no religious faith felt drawn to build this united world, a world with no borders.
Love is a universal language and is applicable wherever we are. Everything, everyone is renewed. Politics and arts, school and religion, private life and entertainment life, everything.
So, here we are now.